Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Gordon Lustig and some phenomenal musicians. He'll be introducing them. Let's welcome them all.
It would be 4 hours long if I did this talking and the music too. And many brothers, and one of them says, "Don't talk too much, just play." He thinks I don't listen to him, but I do. I do. Okay, so you saw my script, you're pretty busy. So I thought if I ever took this on tour, it would be called All for Not. And because I'm not a lot of people, you know, we spend our whole lives trying to figure out who we are, and so I came up with a strategy. I don't know if I could patent it. It would be if you just use process of elimination. Like, there's a lot of people you know you're not, and then you eliminate all those, and then whoever's left, that's probably me. Well, you laugh. That's my strategy. I'm going by that. So that's one person I'm not. When Oliver, my 16-year-old now, but when he was about 50, no, he was about 5 or 6. And I was writing that song, and we were in the car, and you know, he hears it all the time. So he was 5 or 6, and he was very quiet on the way to school one day, and he says, "Daddy, I just thought of 3 more people that you're not." I mean, anyway, Uncle Glen. And you know what? He's a really smart kid. He was right. So a lot of the tonight is what it's going to be is me, the rabbi started this thing, to wanted to honor me. And so it gave me an opportunity to get some great musicians and to kind of, in front of my friends and community, honor the people who have influenced me. And James Taylor was one. And the next person, it started chronologically. So chronologically would be, my parents. So I'm gonna do a song that my dad, we grew up with tons of music in the house. I brought some of the records and 45s that we had. You'll see later, just over here in Social Hall. So this is one of the songs that we used to hear all the time in the house. It's by the Ames Brothers. Before I do that, let me give you a little taste of my dad. I have a whole video thing planned, but I think you'll get the gist. Some of the things he used to just say at the dinner table. Hey kids, I'm in apple blossom time, Orange, New Jersey, or we'll make a peach of a pear. Although we can't elope, oh honey, do you mind? Is that a banana or your nose? Now, he didn't have the guitar accompaniment, so but he did have a beautiful voice. I wish I had his voice. Now, here's my favorite, I still don't understand it. It still makes me laugh. Okay, old Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to give her dog a banana. You remember this? You know where it's going, Julia? But when she got there, the cupboard was bare, so the poor dog had to have sponge cake. Listen, I'm not saying it's funny, but this was my life. And you're going to get a big taste of it. So here's a song. It may not be what you bargained for, but here's a song. I'm just going to stick to this guitar. Right?
This one okay.
Great. It's the first time doing this with my. It's okay. So this is by the Ames Brothers. And I got to teach you. You have a part. Okay. That's my song leading thing. You're going to go like this.
Let's see what key we're in.
Oh, okay. We'll be in C minor.
How about we play in the same key, guys? You like that idea?
So you're going to do it to like a nigun. Okay? Mm-hmm. Jason Lindy will help to walk around the room if they need to. Goes like this. Bum ba da bum 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 bum. Okay. That's on your part. The only time it gets a little complicated is that it changes keys three times, but your part stays the same. So you'll know when that part comes out. I'll help you with it. One, two, three, and.
She lay as
naughty lady, Shady Lane. We still have a 45 laying around somewhere. Oh, it's going to bring 45 to show. For those younger people who don't know what 45 is, it has a very different, scarier connotation now, 45. But in the old days, it meant a little record with a big thing. So, let's see. Okay, so then moving on. So that's what I was listening to when I was a little kid. And then I was given a guitar for Hanukkah around, I was close to 11, I think. I asked for one for many, many years. My mom said, let's do piano first. And I did for a few years. And it was actually a good idea. I tell all my students, my parents, should we start with guitars with piano. So it was a good choice. How come she's sitting right over there? She did a lot of stuff. I just started checking with the boss, right? The nosebleed seats, right? my sister brought me a guitar. She delivered it. She was the messenger because she was, how old were you? Like nine or something. She's nine. Eight or nine. And I have the guitar here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Come on out. Oh, okay, I got to get it.
You have to stand. Let me see if I can get up. Because I did bring it. Let's see who can reach it without dropping their instrument first.
Oh, no.
Okay. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
I wanted to be Buck Owens, so I started to paint it red, white, and blue, like his guitar, using those paint sets that you get with the coloring your paint books, the little tin with the little paint. It didn't work. And as you can see, when my sister gave it to me, she said, listen, no strings attached with this guitar. And as you can see, there's still no strings attached. But I played this guitar for about 5 years. I don't think you can buy a guitar this awful today. They don't make them this bad, and they make a lot of bad instruments, but this is just basically a piece of wood. But it was my piece of wood.
Thanks.
So, here's a song that I wrote, one of my first songs that was actually a song. I played this in the talent show about 6 years. There's no need to applaud, this is just like a history lesson. The sky is blue, there's no more rain. The rainbow's filled with magical things. The birds ascend to the topmost tree. While down below buzz the honeybees, the earth is turning round and round. No one knows how long. Just the wonder of our world, and that's why I'm singing my song. Now the sky is darkening, the moon is out, it's sparkling. People go to sleep at night, only seeing by the moonlight. The earth is turning round and round. How long? It's just the wonder of our world. That's why I'm singing my song. It's just the wonder of our world. That's why I'm singing my song. So I lost the talent show to Renee, who came out in a very see-through sixth grade, right? Purple thing and danced. This improv dance to Aquarius. And that's been my life ever since.
She's here tonight.
Come on out. Seventh grade. Seventh grade. That was great. I met Miss Patrick, my band teacher, and she gave me a record, and I have that record here tonight.
Right here.
She didn't give me this. She was teaching. She was a band director. She also taught guitar. She probably had started learning guitar about a day before the guitar program started, because that's what they do. Hey, you're going to teach guitar too. So she heard me play a little bit, and she gave me this record. I don't know if you can see it. It's Johnny, get some light. No. Can you see that in the monitor? They say all this stuff on TV. I never really knew why. So this is John Denver's greatest hits. And there he is. And she said, I'd never heard of them. I mean, they played stuff on radio, but I wasn't aware of them. And she gave me this record, said, there's a few songs on here. I was wondering if you could write the chords out for me. So I did. Although I did more than she asked, which is unusual. Right? And what I did is I did the whole record. And she says, why don't you just keep the record? And I did. So this is the actual record she gave me in seventh grade. I'm not one to keep things. It's just this thing, you know, when you have 30 John Denver records, you can usually keep them together. So
that's what I'm...
So what I'm going to do right now, I hope we have time, I'm going to do every song on the record. I think I'm joking, Richard, but look, here's my thing. John Denver's greatest hit, Side A, Side B. You see that? Okay. So, I hope you guys ate.
night when I have to go. Talk of only prayers, promises, things we believe in. How sweet it is to love someone, how right it is to care. How long it's been since yesterday. What about tomorrow? What about our dreams and all the memories we share? And the Colorado rocking on high.
Having to do that, you know? Okay, great. Those are nice songs. You know, next year, I have the good fortune of playing at a three-day festival in Aspen, Colorado to celebrate, believe it or not, ready? 20 years since John Denver died.
Wow.
And they're having a big 20th anniversary in Aspen, and they've asked me to be the house guitar player for 3 days. They might need string players, that's true. And you can ask my family, I've been practicing for this gig for about 45 years. okay, let's see, we have an audio clip. I don't know if it's after this one. Probably, yeah, it would be after this one. Okay, so this is a song that my brother Greg asks for all the time. I don't know if I've ever played it upon request, but I'm gonna play it now, because he asked for it. And with orchestra and everything, so you know, it's special. It's called The Blind Man. I wrote this song.
Lustig Phil.
Yeah, Lustig Phil. Phil, there is a Phil Lustig.
Isn't there?
Yeah, Lustig Phil.
We're the Lustig.
Oh, you are the Lustig Phil. I get it. Surround yourself with Jews, and this is what it was like at rehearsal. They go, "Can we stop joking around and get to practice?" Okay, so this, I wrote this on the bus on the way to something. Okay, it goes like this. When I was about 50, it goes like this. 1, 2, 3, and...
But in his heart he knows
thank the rabbi. I can't thank him enough because this is what I've always wanted to do. Let's see. Okay, so it's going to be pretty sappy. So after, we're going to go a little bit out of order because John Denver was like seventh grade. But prior to that, the first person that I really wanted to play guitar that inspired me was the guy you'll hear in this clip. Oh, I see. I skipped clip one. That's right. No problem. We'll go to clip two.
From Television City in Hollywood.
It's knowing that you know is always a woman that is free to walk.
I'm Glen Campbell. Here's some of the people we have
on the show. Glen Campbell. And my mom and I went to see him a few years ago. I had seen him years ago when he was in his prime, Circle Star Theater, along with every other famous person you've ever heard, that's amazing singer, the Jackson 5, the Carpenters. I think my mom went and saw Neil Diamond one night. And everybody, you name it, Ray Charles, Willie Nelson, every comedian. My dad ushered the shows. He took us to everything. You know, you drag, come on, Gordon, come on. You know, it's like, you know, we didn't appreciate it. So, losing my train of thought, but that's all right. I'll just go into the song. So, here's my three of Glen Campbell's biggest hits. Just very brief. I arranged for these guys, and you'll recognize all three. All written by Jimmy Webb. Wrote most of these probably before he was 20. It could be honoring him. He was incredible. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, and. I am a lineman for the county. Drive the main road, searching in the sun for another overload. I hear you singing in the wire. I can hear you through the wine, but the Wichita line is still on the line. By the time I make Oklahoma, she'll be sleeping. She'll turn softly and call my name out low. She'll cry just to think I'd leave her. Though time I've tried to tell her so, she just didn't know I would really go. Here's how I spent the last 3 days, you know, I spent a lot of time doing this, and that was, where is Max in here? Max, can you yell out what it was I was looking for? Okay, thanks. We practiced this for 2 days. We practiced this. Okay, it was a xylophone. I wanted a xylophone. Oh, and a judge going, oh, yeah. for this, so we don't have it. So we're going to have to just, like, make some funny sound. You'll all know where it goes, okay? You'll hear it, and just you'll fill in the spot, okay? You ready, guys? Okay. You're there. There's Kurt. Kurt Nystrom on trumpet. A 1, 2, 3, 4. I used to go with my dad. He sang my whole life, his whole life, in glee clubs and stuff. And I used to go with him, 10, 11 years old. And listen, I'd sit in the bass and the baritone section and listen to him sing his parts. And that's where I learned a lot of the songs I knew today. And I always was doing one of the songs, Raindrops Keep Falling in My Head, as I learned it from my dad. But I extended it into a little medley of songs called the Men of Music Medley, which my dad, that was the name of his group, the Men of Music. And so I just want to sing a few of the songs that he did. You'll recognize them, I'll tell you what they are right now, in case you don't for some reason. But Raindrops Keep Falling in My Head, We've Only Just Begun, Paul Williams, let's see, what else are we doing? Going Out of My Head, I should remember that, I Think I'm Going Out of My Head. And the last one you'll recognize is very popular, probably one of the most popular songs in the world today. I remember this is sitting with my dad, just I learned his parts, and this is how I learned the songs, and to this day still know them. Raindrops keep falling on my moon. Too big for his boom. No, I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because we've only just begun to live. Ooh, wow, ooh. Promises, learn to run. Ba, 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 ooh, yeah, okay, sure. Let's play clip three. Okay. Barbara Lustig, ladies and gentlemen. Chopin. Alive. Chopin alive. Did you recognize that performer? Oh, you did. You didn't say, oh, that sounds like... Well, see, I can't even think of one of the greats right now. But anyway, so that was my mom's playing piano all the time, classical. We had every kind of music in the house that you can imagine. We even sang around the piano, all of us, Mary Poppins songs and stuff like that. It was weird, but really the perfect home, I must say. That was a joke, but listen, if I hold the pickup, I don't know if you can see it, I used to do this at camp, that means that it's a joke, and I'll, so you'll know, I don't want to make you guys work too hard. Okay, so let's see, this is a song I wrote around that time. The reason I think I picked that is because I incorporated that melody into the song, not a week ago, but when I wrote it, I incorporated this, and you'll hear it just a little bit later in the song, so... Ba da 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 da. That's the melody. So this is a song I wrote when I was 19. I think I could have written it today. I could write it today. It's called "Calling the Children Home." It goes like this. Maybe my family will recognize it.
You guys play it again?
Just me? Oh. 1, 2. Hi, son. It's good to see you. Didn't expect you home today. My son, how we missed you. Things aren't the same when you're away. Just last night, your father and I were looking at photographs. We knew the time would come when all the kids would be gone, but we never thought it happened so fast. This old house is empty now, leaving the old folks alone. This old house is calling the children home. Hi, son, so glad you phoned me. Good to hear your sweet hello. My son, your brother told me he heard you on the radio. Just last week, your father and I, we found your guitar in the shed.
Thank you.
I'll just go by that. Okay, now to lighten up the mood. Okay. Do I know this one? Oh, okay, yeah, I was going to invite, actually, we're going to take a minute. We're going to take a minute to for a little public service announcement. So, let's see, I had asked somebody to come up here, a doctor. Is there a doctor in the fish? You know that maybe? Oh, here we go. Marty Spitz, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see here, I'll just hand you this. Just don't aim it to the speaker, unless the general's in the house and give them.
Gordon, I have this.
Ah, okay. Oh, Jeremy's back there. Okay, that's fine. Is that one still working? Is it on?
Yeah, Jeremy put it on.
It's back there.
Oh, can you put the other
chair? Yeah, go ahead, just hit it once. Make sure we're. Good, we're good.
It's fine.
Good, okay.
Yeah. I'm actually wearing a coat that says Dr. Pascan. And I'm actually Dr. Pascan with microcephaly.
I got to talk to that pop. Go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, you're on live. Okay, this is streaming all over the internet.
Actually, Gordon wanted me...
Just talk right into the mic.
I will. Gordon wanted me to tell you about sigmoidoscopy. And a sigmoidoscope is a flexible 2-foot tall tube that goes from one end to
the other. Ah, okay.
That's pretty good. Want to tell you a joke?
No.
Okay.
We won't tell you a joke. Who took the.
Oh, it's Jeremy. Yeah,
Jeremy's just being real quiet. Yeah, great. You can give that one. That's all right. The rabbi seemed very disappointed that there was not a demonstration. But there will be demonstrations after the show in your office. In your office, we'll leave it there. My wife told me that wouldn't be funny, but I said, that's a big sign, I'm going to do it. Listen, you know, how bad can it be? Sigmoidoscopy on ukulele. So you get the idea. It's not a colonoscopy. It's a different thing. And this song will explain why, you know, my story. Okay. And you can applaud at the end if you're still here. Yeah, you can use it. Because I'll never think of it again.
Sigmoidoscopy.
Raise your hand if you've not had a sigmoidoscopy.
My philosophy was it wouldn't hurt to have a sigmoidoscopy.
Coming up on 9 till we went to
they only gave me ointment to make me slick. They offered not a single analgesic. Can a person with a scope traversing through the large intestine? Go on living, ever hope to smile again? Now that's the question. And tomorrow, should you tell me you're about to go and get it, I can promise you, you will live to regret it. Is my friend, it's just impossible. Impassable.
Hey, boys.
When the night before is the worst part of it. Kindly recommend they take their prep and shove it. And have yourself a blissful colonoscopy. My new philosophy. Non-a-sigmoidoscopy.
Karen was pregnant, I just thought it'd be a girl, so I wrote this song, okay? We don't have any girls, but this is the song I wrote just in case. I like to prepare. I can do my prep. I did it the night before. Okay. A 1, 2, 3, 4.
Every night I sit with my honey pie, drinking in her delectable face. When she's feeling less than sunny, I sing her a ditty, then she's sitting pretty. Every day she's new with a stranger, wide eyes peeking through a delicate frizz. I have no desire to change her, I love her just the way she is. Never used to be so happy, I was not one for childish ways. Now I'm silly and sappy. Since I caught her wildish gaze, when she smiles, my heart is as timpani. When she laughs, my head's in a whirl. I'm her song, and she's my symphony. Oh, how I love that
I've seen them once in 30 years and that recently, but we've been so close the whole time. Anyway, so the rabbi, when I was 12 years old, he sent me to Camp Swig, the Jewish summer camp. And because I was starting to do music in the synagogue, he wanted me to learn what the contemporary music was. So I did. I made friends that have been friends for a lifetime. But the first person that I met when I was sent up there, actually, I went again when I was 18. 13, I went for a session as a kid. Then I went again as 18, they called me and hired me to be at camp when I was 18. And I had to learn like 50 songs between about, I think it was like 4 in the afternoon and 2 a.m. It was crash course because I had to go teach you something. But I had the best teacher in the world you could possibly have, and that's who was helping lead services. And we've known each other, that was about 1970, that was 1978, so that's when we met. And we've never lost touch, and he's just, I thought he was kind of too good to be true, probably like Lindy did, you know. And when I met him, he's just an amazing mensch of a guy. I've never met anybody like that. And he's never been different than that. This is amazing. So I was trying to think of all the friends and people that I wanted to come and sing tonight with me, and I couldn't. After them, I thought, you know, I don't think there is anybody else. So Jason and Lindy, they're here to help me. They're going to sing on a few songs. I would like to invite Jason, Rabbi Jason Gladstaff, cantor, Lindy Passer with the green eyes, to come up and help me sing. Am I on the wrong set? Wrong set? Oh, that's right. We were going to do that. Okay. That's fine. Oh, I see where we are. Yeah. Okay. We're good. This is just the rehearsal taping. We're doing the real show tonight. Yeah, with the real audience, and it would be great. But thank you for filling the seats for today. Hope you didn't have to wait in line.
Oh, yeah, okay. That's right, Jason.
Okay. So, we're going to start by Lindy really said she needed to warm up her voice first. So, I came up with a little ditty to help her do that. Okay? Make sure that that's right. Yeah. Yeah,
she's,
yeah, of course.
I know.
Think back. Okay. You'll recognize this as soon as you hear it. My roadies didn't show up tonight, so I don't know. Oh, well. There we go. Okay, and we're ready. I appreciate you waiting around. Let's see. Here we go. The pros, they make it look easy, don't they? Okay. She doesn't know what she's doing. They never rehearsed. Okay. So, I start. Well, we all start. One, let's see. One, two. Okay, great. Thank you very much. Star Trek, that was the original series, without the voiceover, okay, in case, for those keeping track. There's a Trekkie convention coming up, right, Karen? Where is that? What? Oh, those that aren't in my show, they're at a Trekkie convention right now, singing this very song. Okay. We're going to do a song that I wrote in 1979 at Camp Swig. This is, we're not doing that one? Sorry. 12, 13. Oh, Lindy and I are going to do a song. I'm not following my own list. Throw that away. Just pay no attention to this. See, this has been great training. When you're up there with the rabbi, you're ready for anything. You are. Did I pass it? There it is. Okay. We're going to do this song. So this was written for a play, just a little play at a little school. At a little Jewish school, and called The Adventures of Mensch Girl. And like, yeah. Anyway, I won't go into it. We'll just sing it. It's got that Archie Eva thing going for it. But I've never done it with another person, so Lindy, this will be our first time. Here we go.
Isn't it nice to have a family? Wasn't it the best thing that we did? I couldn't ask for anything more from life than you and our fine kids. Had anyone tried to tell me years ago how happy I would be, I wouldn't have believed it.
Wouldn't have believed it.
Wouldn't have believed it. About the sleepless nights, all the fussing and the fights, all the spilling and the drooling on their bibs.
What about the curls and the coos, little feet and tiny shoes, how we could gaze at them for hours in our cribs? Had anyone tried to tell me years ago how lucky I would be, I wouldn't have believed it.
Wouldn't have believed it.
Wouldn't have believed it. Believe you me.
Come to think of it, dear, there are some wonderful memories. Then there were their first words spoken.
Our nice things broken.
Baseball.
The sacrifice they made.
What about the snuggles and the hugs?
Tracking dirt upon the rugs.
And all the memories, time will never fade.
Had anyone tried to tell me years ago what kids would put me through, I wouldn't have believed it.
Wouldn't have believed it.
Wouldn't have believed it.
And you were in the family way, and everything was
great. Oh, then we had three ladies and a sir. Perfect.
Funny how the time can pass. We're lucky we have photographs, 'cause every day since they were born was just a blur.
Isn't it nice to have a family? Wasn't it the wisest thing we've done? Believed it, but I believe it now.
I think they're doing a version of that in Hamilton right now, so you can catch it. little twist. Okay. Something's feeding back. Okay, so here's another song that I wrote at camp. It's in Hebrew. It means all of us are connected. We are all connected. The entire world is connected. It's important that we love and treat each other kindly and with respect, which we are all doing. We're all here doing that right now, and that's really what matters. So this is called Kol Yisrael. All of Israel, all the people of the world are connected. Jason co-wrote this with me. It goes like this.
Thank you.
set with the first song I wrote at camp in 78, and you're in it, Jason. Actually, it was 79. 79. Like, maybe he's keeping track. Just move on. I went into the staff lounge or the program director's area, and he said, "Hey, Gordon," it was kind of like, "Do you write songs?" Because it was like, this is my first song. "Yeah, we need a song for the Song and Dance Festival." This is like 10 or 11 at night. These people stayed up all night, just all night, on their pencils. On their pencils. Stayed up all night on their pencils. There were no computers. And so they said, "We need a song for the Song and Dance Festival." I go, "Great. When do you need it by?" "Tomorrow morning." So I had it to them, I think by 1 a.m. Remember? I don't know where you were. You were staying up all night somewhere else. But anyway, they said, "Not one of your better songs." We showed them, huh? But checks keep coming. Okay. So. Right from the Bible, right from Genesis, God saw all that was created, said, "It's very good. There was evening, there was morning, it was very good."
Oh,